What happens when Neuralink unites with ChatGPT-5, which is coming out, and Gemini? Could we then at that point in time see a transhumanism revolution that will impact humanity in ways that most cannot even imagine? That's their plans. That's their agenda.
Run also, they have this goal to enhance human intelligence to be able to compete, as they say, with an AI if we'll need it later on. And I'll get back to that in a second. But how does it actually work? Well, there's a microchip in the case of Neuralink. It's called telepathy. It's the size of a coin, and it's going to be implemented directly inside the brain in a region that controls the movement intention, so at the top of the skull. And additionally, you're going to have 3,000 microelectrodes that are going to be implanted directly on the neurons, and they're going to be able to decode and record neural signals. So when you want to grab something, let's say with your right hand, you have a very specific neural signal for that. And what the chips can do is they can pick up on that, send it through Bluetooth to a computer or a telephone, decipher and act upon it. So indeed, it can help quadriplegic people in a big way because they can now control the computer.
However, I have a spoiler alert. For the elite of this world, I have a spoiler alert for transhumanists everywhere. And we're gonna talk about that spoiler alert as this video continues. Here we have the first man with Neuralink implant, and he is learning French. He's now planning on finishing a degree, and he's learning other different languages, all because he now has a microchip in his brain. And what this is allowing them to do is to essentially convert man into a machine. Technologies like ChatGPT, Neuralink, and many others like Gemini and others that are being brought forth, what they are allowing, in my personal opinion, is for unclean spirits. It's for the same spirits that you heard of in Mark 5, 8 through 9. For he said unto him, come out of the man, thou unclean spirit. And he asked him, what is thy name? And he answered, saying, my name is Legion. For we are many. Transhumanism, humanoids, future humanoid avatars, Neuralink, ChatGPT. This is allowing these unclean spirits a vessel that people will accept, love, and embrace because of convenience. But I caution you, 2 Corinthians 11:14. Satan comes as an angel of light, but take a look at how Microsoft and Bill Gates, they're embracing the age of transhumanism.
This is work.
What's up, Mike?
We're giving eyes and ears to AI. We're giving eyes and ears to AI. We're giving eyes and ears to AI. So the world becomes your prompt and your interface. This is work. Working. These are thoughts happening.
Hey, Copilot.
Plans populating.
Copilot, when was this last replaced?
Information gathering. Instructions guiding. Schematics aligning. People connecting. Problem solving.
Copilot?
Hey, Copilot. Copilot.
This is confidence growing. Eyes widening. These are questions.
I just finished, Copilot. What's next?
Rotate the engine block 90 degrees.
Questions the way you ask them.
Please get me the detailed view of the optical cable layout.
Never too many questions.
All right. Let's highlight the relay switches.
Go ahead. Keep asking.
It's in position. What's next?
Keep learning.
The hydraulic filter was changed 6 months ago.
Okay, can you pull up the service record?
Copilot, what's the tolerance of this locking ring?
Here is a copy of the last service record. The tolerance is 9,000ths of an inch.
Remind me where this fits into the assembly.
Step 4, align the spindle. The locking ring is highlighted.
This is work getting smarter. This is work working better. This is work working. This is work.
The FDA, the Federal Drug Administration, the administration that's supposed to look out for your health, is fully embracing the mixture of man and machine. Elon Musk says, update about the second Neuralink device in a human. If all goes well, there will be hundreds of people with Neuralinks within a few years, maybe tens of thousands within 5 years, millions within 10 years. Millions within 10 years. And when you combine Neuralink and its brain interface system with ChatGPT, as they're intending to at some point in time do, what you will have is, according to them, is a vessel that's no longer human. They're half human, half robot, but they're powered by AI. You know, I went to ChatGPT and I typed it a question. I said, in regards to Neuralink, do you think it will ever merge with ChatGPT or Gemini? And it's amazing because within a fraction of a second, it had a response. It said the idea of merging Neuralink with AI systems like ChatGPT or Google's Gemini. Notice that I didn't even say Google Gemini, but it understood what I was saying. It's fascinating and raises some intriguing possibilities. Neuralink, founded by Elon Musk, focuses on developing brain-computer interfaces that aim to bridge the gap between human brains and computers. This technology could potentially enable direct communication between our brains and AI systems, because when you take the Neuralink technology and you combine it with ChatGPT, no longer will you have to type a question to ChatGPT or Gemini. Now you'll be able to simply think a thought, like in the movie The Matrix, where they can learn Kung Fu, right? And the enticement that's going to provide to human beings to unite with transhumanism is going to be astronomical. And they're going to tell you that it's going to be a seamless transaction, seamless interaction. You'll be smarter. You can finally get the job that you want. In fact, I wouldn't rule it past them to say in qualifications for employment, do you have a Neuralink device? It may not even be called that. But this is something that will at some point in time or another separate the species on Earth. You're gonna have the God-created human being and transhumanists. And because Satan is a slanderer, he's always gonna be talking down against the human being. But I told you that we have a spoiler alert. In Mark 5, 8 through 9, we saw that they are legions, but these legions can be rebuked and casted out in the name of Jesus. In Jude 9, when Michael the Archangel was contending with the devil, he dared not bring railing accusations, but he said, what? The Lord rebuke thee. Whatever is operating behind these entities, the entities that are operating behind these devices are the same entities that have operated through Ouija boards and paranormal activity events. They're just doing it in a different package. It's a package that seems enticing. With Microsoft, you saw there clearly that they can take your business and your company to the next level, because one employee that may have a brain chip interface with AI can possibly do the function of 10 or 15 employees because of the knowledge base that it's going to provide them. But better is to have little with the Lord, my family members in Christ, and better is to use wisdom and understanding that what we're dealing with here is not technology, that what we're dealing with here is witchcraft and its entities. It's fallen angel technology, and the rebellion that they're doing in 2024, 2025, and the coming years is no different than the Tower of Babel. And there you have your spoiler alert. They rose up in rebellion against the Most High. They rose up in rebellion thinking that they could come against the one that brought the flood. Nimrod's end wasn't a good one. The Tower of Babel was destroyed. God is telling you in Revelation 18 to come out from among her, my people. It's because the judgment that is coming upon this earth at one point in time or another, you want no part of. So as these devices begin to become popular, as mainstream picks up transhumanism and DNA modification to make you a better human, I like to keep things simple. Why don't we just become better ambassadors of the kingdom of Jesus Christ now, so that all of our decision making so that the way that we talk, the way that we act, the decisions that we make as humans honors the Heavenly Father and demonstrates our love for the Heavenly Father, because these are going to be the moments that will prepare you for, what, 10, 15 years down the road when you're competing for employment with someone who has a brain chip interface, who has AI on their side. It's intimidating for the natural man to comprehend this. But for the spiritual man who has the Holy Spirit, you understand that you have the Holy Spirit who teaches you all things, who tells you what to say before you even say it. ChatGPT, Gemini, transhumanism, brain chips, all these are is Satan trying to be like the Most High. He's not omnipresent, so he's creating his own mini version of omnipresence by trying to spy on your brain with ChatGPT and Neuralink. He's trying to be like the Most High, but he is going to fail. As these intimidation tactics start to grow, you need to grow more in the Lord and follow his commandments and follow his instructions. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, thank you, because before any of these technologies were available to give us quote-unquote knowledge, you promised us the Comforter that not only gives us knowledge, godly knowledge, but you give us peace and you give us wisdom and you give us instructions and you give us discernment, and you're giving it to us for free. It's a free choice that you give humanity, to take that choice for free. You're so awesome. Every day, Heavenly Father, when I see the devil come up with the new technology, it's just trying to mimic what you've already done. And yet he continues because he knows that his time is short. Convict the hearts of many brothers and sisters in the Lord that are watching this today, for them to redeem the time for the days of evil, and for them to start today, right now, to live for you, because you're coming soon. And because you're giving us all of these life lessons that we're going through, whether it's anxiety, whether it's depression, whether it's trauma, whether it's family members betraying you, friends betraying you, whether it's hurts, whatever it could be, you're giving us all of these lessons for us to get ready for what lies ahead. And when we see what lies ahead, and when we see the crazy diabolical things that they're gonna unleash, if we pass these tests today, we're gonna be able to see those events and say, wow, God is awesome. He got me ready. He got me ready. In the name of Jesus, amen. God bless you guys. Thank you for passing by again. Would you mind taking a few seconds just to press the thumbs up button? These are non-monetized channels, just like many others on YouTube. Without you pressing the thumbs up button or sharing these videos, they will get absolutely no traction. And our aim is to reach one person for Jesus Christ. And with your help, we can definitely do that. Also, subscribe to the channel. It's a blessing for you to do that. We have weekly content on here. We also have a secondary channel which has daily encouragement. I'm going to leave an encouragement on the screen right now. That's from our secondary channel. That's also a channel where you can get daily encouragement, Sabbath services, Wednesday services, a lot more interaction on there for free as well. Thank you for supporting this ministry. Thank you for supporting this channel. It goes a very long way, much more than you could ever imagine. So thank you for being a partner with us, and see you on that second channel. The video's on the screen now. Check it out. It's different style of videos, but they're aimed at encouraging you throughout the week. Jesus is the only way. God bless.